Henry Kaiser here, weekly solo number 25, The Lost Solo. Okay, back in the earlier days of the pandemic, when there were the giant wildfires here in California and we were evacuated from our home, I was working on several different solos at once, weekly solo 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, etc., 27. And I had them all in the editing program working a little bit on this one this week, a little bit on that one that week. And somehow 25 got lost and never got uploaded. We just skipped a number and it's been sitting there all along. So I've made this new introduction for it. And this is the Henry Kaiser Quartet back in 1990. We're playing in October at a gig place called Wetlands in New York City. But before we get to that show, which is from an old VHS tape and not the best quality, I put something entertaining here at the top before the long live concert, which is probably just of interest to specialists. This thing at the top's kind of fun. I found a studio recording that had not been released of the Henry Kaiser Quartet playing the Grateful Dead's tune as an instrumental, Blues for Allah, Blues for Allah. And the band is me, Henry Kaiser on guitar, John McCain Jr. on guitar, amazing guitarist. I met way back then. We had a lot of fun together. He is a master of a lot of things. He can play like George Van Epps. He can do the legato Holdsworth stuff. He studied slack key with masters in Hawaii like Raymond Kane. Amazing musician. I haven't got a chance to work with him for quite a few years, but boy, what a great musician. And on bass, Mr. Gary Lambert, an old friend of mine who's been very active in the Grateful Dead scene for a long time. Nowadays, you will see his writings in the Grateful Dead Almanac, and you'll hear him on the Grateful Dead radio show, et cetera, et cetera. I miss him. He moved to New York a while ago, and we haven't played together for years. Terrific bass player. We did a lot of different little band projects together and had a lot of fun. On drums in the Henry Kaiser Quartet, Mr. Mark McQuaid Crawford, who was in the band Name with me and a bunch of other little projects. We haven't played together in a long, long, long time either. And I miss him. Mark's a terrific drummer, one of the best drummers I've played with. He studied with Narada Michael Walden before I met him, and he's a force of nature. So here we are with this band, which is a fun band. I'll tell you a little more about that later, but let's hear Blues for Allah, studio version, unreleased. And I think I'll make it interesting by putting an old 1959 Egyptian science fiction movie visuals with it, a movie called Journey to the Moon. And it fits the music and it's fun. So here we go, Blues for Allah.
Thank you.
Blues for Allah on the Moon. Okay, so this place in New York, it was a jam band kind of club in 1990, Wetlands. And what were we? Were we a jam band? Were we an avant-garde band? What were we? Who knows? You know, since my college days, when I was in the Monster Island band with Owen Merricks, or in the late 70s in Name, we were doing things that were jam bandy things before there were official jam bands like Phish and so on and so forth. And we were being very eclectic, putting a lot of different things together, as you'll see in this gig. I think the giant sequoia in the forest of this kind of music is the Hampton Grease Band, because they took and put together San Francisco psychedelia with Southern rock, put together with Beefheart, with Zappa, with Dadaism. Amazing group. My pal Glenn Phillips, who is one of my favorite guitar players ever, was in that band. So they're the precursor, but we're just doing a bunch of crazy stuff. And what you'll see us doing on stage is having a great time, having as much fun as we possibly can. So I hope you enjoy it. This is long. This is a 2.5-hour show. It's crazy. When we get to the end, the videotape ran out just before we played the tune The Sandman after the solo improvisation that John McCain was starting it off with. So I have taken a studio version of The Sandman back from those days and stuck that at the end and put some animation on it. Oddly enough, it's from an NPR live radio show that we did the night before in New York City. And on that was the great writer James Ellroy. And we played behind him reading. It was terrific. And he has the last word here in this show, Mr. James Ellroy. Okay. Thanks for joining us. From now on, it's the monthly solo. You probably know that. Once a month, first of each month. No more weekly solo, monthly solo. Thanks a lot for joining us. See you next month. Bye.
Again, this is Gary Lambert on bass. We're introducing Mr. John McCain, all the way from Hawaii, on guitar. And he's a barefoot, by the way you can tell. And Mr. Mark McQuaid Crawford on the drums. And, well, Gary, what should we play?
We're Wetlands.
Play some cymbals. Play some cymbals. Now, for a man in the cymbals, I think you
make up a song.
Richard Dare.
playing up in Canada, up near Montreal.
Where everybody calls Henry LeCave.
Yes, thank you. And we went for a walk in the forest there, and we met a new friend, the Blue Moose.
Oh.
And we wrote this song about him, the Blue Moose, for you. One moment, we'll bring him out. Just a moment.
We didn't write this song in the
no, Bob.
Henry.
Yes,
we did. Okay. You're forgetting.
Oh, I forgot.
Yeah,
we
yeah.
Very
good
story.
Okay.
Should I treat this for us?
Nah. Thanks a lot.
No, it is.
Switch guitar.
Henry's gonna switch guitars, and we should mention that. While we were walking through the woods in Canada, our friend Bob Adams from California was neurotransmitting these songs to us in the guise of a Blue Moose. He was kind of a shamanistic. Bob's kind of a shaman, and remember,
but please don't squeeze
the shaman. Right? We'll be right back.
dilemma. Because here we are, we're supposed to be this avant-garde weird band that went to play this festival up in Canada, but we know people here like to have fun, but we know some people can't because they want the avant-garde really weird stuff that we can still play. But we know some people want to have fun too, so we'll be sort of schizoid.
we're really disordered. We're playing at this festival in Canada, and they gave us these badges that say Artiste. And we walked around this town feeling like artistes. You know, here we are, we're playing with Bacay. We are artistes. Then Mark called his lovely wife, Amanda McQuaid Crawford, in Northern California, and said, "Honey, I'm walking around this town in Canada with a badge that says artiste." And she just about died laughing, didn't she, Mark? So that brought us back down to earth. We realized, we're just a regular bunch of... We'll be right back. your brand new leopard. Well, I see you got your brand new leopard skin. Well, I see you got your brand new leopard skin pill. Well, 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 I see you got your brand new leopard skin pill, I can. And would like more of my bass in the monitor.
We're gonna
Mark, it's a whole lot better when you don't hear me. But...
what now? Well, we're gonna bring it down a little bit for just a moment. The most recent of my friend Bob Adams, who was in the group Name with Crazy Backwards Alphabet with me, compositions that we've attempted to learn, is this new one, which is about what it's like to grow up next door to Disneyland and then have to spend the rest of your life managing a uniform laundry. And that's the subject of this next composition.
I think we've all experienced that.
Thank you.
playing slippery guitar.
No set list. Here's the list.
We all start with set list.
No.
Let's
do Pepper
Lock. Yeah.
This is a new tune by Richard Thompson.
Yeah! I'll put this on the new French French Thompson album, which is out today.
I was going to sing it in Norwegian, but...
Did you say it in Norwegian?
No, I don't got it. So I didn't know whether to do it like Elvis or Devo. So it kind of goes in between Elvis and Devo. We'll be right back.
say, John? You know, that vibrato that you used on that tune sort of reminds me of a little known fact about John McCain. You may not know it, but a long time ago, back around 1939, before he took some growth hormones, John had a bit part in a very famous movie. Yeah, it was a small part. He had one line.
Has coroner eyes, I'm in her, I thoroughly examined her, and she's not merely, merely dead, she's merely most sincerely dead.
The coroner of Munchkin Land, ladies and gentlemen, John McCain. Thank you. There's many other impressions of almost equal quality.
Musician is one.
What now?
Jam.
Huh?
We're jam.
Sandy.
Not Sandy.
You don't
I've heard that.
Well, no, but they don't remember it.
Sandy the Pelican.
Mark Albert would say,
now for that Ranger score. Chuck it a dee da da. Bradley shoots for the key. Yes!
There's a song that John French and I wrote called Welfare Elite.
Some of the symbols. This is really good. white-collar conservative flashing down the street, pointing his plastic finger at me. He hopes mankind will drop and die. But I'm gonna let my freak flag fly. Fight night!
Thank you. never heard a Grateful Dead record. He's never heard Jimmy Garcia. It is by Drew. Treasures are. He's never heard this song. He has no idea what we're doing.
Thank you. pretty sure Mark and I, don't you think so? We saw Walt Whitman driving a cab up Hudson Street. Was that Walt Whitman? I'm pretty sure it was Walt Whitman. Well, now that we've got you dancing,
I don't know why we'll do this, but we'll subject the poor Beef Park fans who are waiting to this first.
Actually, many people believe that Captain Beefheart and Porter Wagoner are the same person. This is a Porter Wagoner song. Porter always liked to kick it up just like that. This is quite possibly the saddest song ever written. So those of you prone to depression, it's pretty strange. Knocked on the warden's door at Sing Sing, then in tears said, "Sir, I understand that 83968 is here. He's my daddy, sir, and I just got to be with him. And if you can't let him out, then you got to let me in. Let me in. Let me in. 83968, my dad. I watched him bury Mama. Now he's all in the world I have. I can break your little rocks with a hammer in my hand. I've just got to be near Daddy. Mr. Warden, please let me in. Make me cry, John. Mama. Well, he had to, because she died.
I could break your little rock with a hammer in my hand. I've just got to be near daddy. Mr. Warden, please let me in. Thank you. Grateful Dead music, if you look at it right.
Make us move!
Huh? Well, in response to that request, Henry, explain yourself.
See, this here one's called Japan in a Dishpan. It was on a Captain Beefheart, I don't recall. Lick My Decals Off Baby, and this is all written.
Thank you. Well, John sends this out to his friend Billy from Hawaii, and we send it. This is a traditional folk song from this land. Traditional folk song written by Bob Adams from this land where they all tune their guitars to this tuning called Dropped D.
Thank you.
do what you do well. Thank you.
crazy, Daddy-O.